watching this video today, COVID-19 has gotten the best of you and us. We had planned a massive launch at a trade show style format to introduce this new product to everyone. Unfortunately, we're going to have to do our video style today. So my name is Curtis Hendrickson. I'm a sales territory manager for Central Saskatchewan.
And I'm Brennan, a design engineer with Bourgault.
So for 2021, I'm really excited to launch the Bourgault air planter. And I brought Brennan along for his good looks and his smarts. He was one of the lead designers in this project, and I'm going to let him talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, we're really excited to supersede your expectations. I know it's a little corny. Okay, I'll stop. Anyways, we're here to introduce this air planter, as Curtis had mentioned here. And really what we're doing with this air planter is we're combining air seeding technology with a new technology to Bourgault, planting technology.
So Brennan, how did this all come about, this idea of a multi-purpose machine?
We were looking at the market and seeing the trends that were kind of coming about here and starting to see more row crop type crops like corn and soybeans shifting further north into the broad acre farms, which typically did smaller grains. But at the same time, we were also seeing those broad acre farms wanting to focus in on their input costs and try and reduce that and make more efficient use of their seed.
Yeah, for sure, Brennan. I mean, you and I both talk to producers every day that talk about $10, $12, $13, $15 a pound canola, and the need to try and control that expense on their farm, and also those customers on the fringe in that corn and soybean growing areas, that's moving further and further north because of the development of shorter season varieties.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Curtis. So I guess without further ado, why don't we talk about this air planter?
This really is the first multi-purpose air planter / air drill on the market today. We're gonna be able to provide this air planter option to either a hoe drill or a coulter drill. Let's go around the back of the machine and show you how this product works. You see with this air planter option, we're still offering a double shoot system. So that gives you the ability to apply all your nitrogen and your seed and your starter fertilizer. How we do that is basically we use a series of inductors to get the product to the meters. And we're literally drawing air off of either line, depending which one has more capacity. And we then control the amount of air pressure the inductor uses or needs by this knife valve. It is that simple to start the process for planting. Once we've got air to the induction system, to change from volumetric seeding with your PDM Pro metering auger to planting is literally a matter of opening a knife valve and then setting your induction plates from the straight through position to the induction mode, and then setting your bypass setting as well. Now these air seeder inductors can be placed under the saddle tank for a product like canola, whether it be tank one for row crops such as soybeans, or whether it be tank three for a row crop like corn, while still giving you the ability to volumetrically place your fertilizer. So once your product is delivered from your air seeder inductors, it comes through this line and up to the drill induction tower, and there is a knife valve at the top. This drill tower then is an inductor just like the inductors on the tank itself. There's bypass settings depending what crop you're delivering and how much you're delivering. And from this induction tower, it sends out product to each of the meters on the drill. So product is delivered from the drill bulk fill tower into the seed columns itself. One delivery line feeds two meters, and this seed column acts as a check valve really between the meter and the bulk fill delivery. So let's just talk about the Bourgault XP meter. It's an electric motor that drives each individual meter, and that gives you turn compensation, also gives you that sectional row by row control coming into a headland. So let's have a closer look at the Bourgault XP meter and what all the components are. So the cover itself consists of a pressure seal inside there to control the seed on the plate, as well as an ejector wheel. The plate itself is obviously crop specific, so you are going to have to change this between crops. Inside the XP meter itself is your singulator, as well as your extractor. So once product is released by the seal, it ends up being delivered to the opener, whether it be a hole drill or a coulter drill style of opener, with the extractor, and is pressurized delivery of that seed to the opener itself. There is a sensor that is counting each individual seed going through the meter, as well as considering the spacing of the seeds going through the meter. So that's your check for skips, doubles, and accuracy of product being delivered.
So you can see from the video that there's really only a couple components that make this system work: the bulk fill system and the metering system. Brennan, why don't you talk a little bit about those two systems?
Yeah, sure. So from the video, you guys could see that in the bulk fill system, we kind of start off with splitting air off of the fans, and then that air running through an inductor on the tank. Now the inductor is basically using that airflow to entrain seed. There's not necessarily any metering going on, but simply just the airflow picking up seed, carrying out of the inductor to the drill.
So Brennan, can we put these inductors under any of the meters on the tank?
Because you can buy it with an inductor under tank 1, 3, or 5. Where tank 1 would be configured for something like soybeans, tank 3 for something like corn, and tank 5 for canola.
Just because the tank size is matching up to the seed population.
And kind of target rate for seeding, yes.
Brennan, do you want to kind of clarify how the second stage of the induction works?
Yeah, Curtis. So we've got a two-stage system here, and what that allowed us to do was to create a first stage that was easily adapted and compatible with our PDM metering system on the air seeder, as well as creating a simple hookup, a single hose onto the drill at the hitch point there. So the seed tower on the drill has a series of inductor bodies below it where each line feeds 2 meters. And at each meter, there's a split to supply product to the 2 meters.
The heart of the machine really is in the meter. So Brennan, can you touch on the meter itself?
Yeah, so the meter operates on a positive pressure, much like the bulk fill system does to deliver seed to each one of these meters. So seed enters through the meter from the seed column and rests against a metering plate. Now as the metering plate rotates, positive pressure inside the meter runs through a vented area and creates a pressure differential to pick up those seeds from the area where the seed enters into the meter. So seeds are held onto each one of the holes on the metering plate, and as it rotates, it passes by a singulating mechanism, which is purposed to remove multiples or multiple seeds held on each one of these holes and leaving a singulated seed. And it continues to rotate, and seed is then released from the metering plate by a seal that cuts off this vented area. And positive pressure inside the meter escapes through a nozzle or an extractor. Now as it does that, it entrains the seed as it's released from the metering plate and then carries it out of the meter.
So we've talked about inducting the seed, we've talked about metering the seed. Now one of the most critical parts is delivering it to the ground. We have two options for our customers. They can purchase this air planter system for either a hole drill or a coulter drill. And in either case, we can deliver product volumetrically or singulated. Brennan, can you elaborate a little bit on that?
Certainly, yeah. So basically the fundamental difference between the hole opener and the disc is how they're opening the soil to place the seed. Now with the hole openers, whether it be the PLX, the PLD, or the PLS, they're relying on soil flow around the backside of the opener to capture that seed, whether it be volumetric or singulated. Whereas with the PLR opener, for the volumetric, it's simply relying on a scraper to place the seed along the bottom of the trench. But for the singulated, it's using a firming wheel to properly place the seed in there before the opener has a chance to close the soil back in over the seed.
And what kind of performance can we expect out of the Bourgault XP meter?
So we'll talk in terms of singulation here, Curtis. It's the percentage of seeds that are released as a single seed at a time. So for corn, you can expect 99% or greater, soybeans 98% or greater, and canola 97% or greater.
So Brennan, are you telling me that we can offer the simplicity of a hole opener and get the accuracy of current planters with double disc openers as far as seed spacing and corn?
That's right, Curtis. We've put many years worth of research and development and in-field testing into the various offerings of this hole opener that we have, and we have absolute confidence that you can expect the same results out of these hole openers as you can out of a double disc application.
Row crops are typically wider spacing. Your coarse grain, corn, soybean, those kind of things are at 15, 20, 24 inch rows, which we offer, meter per row. But in broad acre farming, there's a demand for narrower row spacings. Do we have any way to accommodate that, Brennan?
Yeah, we do, Curtis. You would install a seed splitter into the outlet of the meter, and what it's doing is it's distributing seed from 1 meter into 2 rows.
So Brennan, we've mainly focused on the precision seed placement side of the Bourgault air planter, but we have a tremendous pile of options for somebody wanting to place all forms of nutrients while they seed. It's my understanding that the offering that's available today from competitive planting units really are limited to a couple different options. They're either floating on all their nutrient package using a floater broadcast system and then having to incorporate that, or in the form of starter fertilizer, really they're limited to liquid forms. Is that correct?
Yeah. I mean, current planters are quite limited in their fertilizing capabilities, especially the rates that they can do it at, Curtis. And that's kind of where the Bourgault air planter, you know, really brings a benefit to the producer here. I mean, you've got the ability to put down your high rate fertilizer, your nitrogen down the mid-row banding system, safely placed away from your seed, but you've also got the ability to safely place starter fertilizer with the seed.
Brennan, I think the best way to break this down for everybody on our advantages are to take a specific scenario. So let's take a producer that's from Winnipeg, Grand Forks, Fargo, Central North Dakota, Southern Alberta, these fellas that are growing canola, they're growing corn, they're growing soybeans, they're growing wheat, all the crops that we can handle now. So it's a Wednesday afternoon at 3 o'clock and I'm seeding wheat with my 9950 air seeder tank coupled to a 76 foot 3335 high flow drill, and I'm seeding wheat. My boss comes to the field and says, Curtis, it's time to go seed corn. Kind of help me break that down into what's involved.
For a crop like corn, we would likely pick tank 3, kind of a medium-sized tank to throw the corn seed into. So at a 100 bushel tank, assuming an average seeding rate for corn.
Yeah, I think my boss had told me, let's shoot for 30,000 seeds per acre.
Yep, so that would be pretty typical, and that would get you 425 acres out of a fill. And then for tank 4, that's likely where we'd put our starter fertilizer, which you can place safely with the seed. And at 220 bushel, at a typical starter fertilizer blend and rate, you'd be looking at about 400 acres per fill. And this is kind of the big benefit here, being able to put down a bulk rate through the mid-row banding system.
And so my boss had said target for that 175 pounds of N?
Sure, of actual N you're
of
referring to?
N, I'm
yeah,
talking
okay.
about, yeah.
Of actual N here, yeah. So tank 1 and 2 capacity together, we're looking at 530 bushels. And at what you're telling me there, doing the math, you could get 86 acres per fill.
So you're telling me that when I pull into a quarter section, if I'm full, I only need to fill that urea tank once to finish off a quarter of corn?
That's right.
Bourgault was fortunate to work with several cooperators in Saskatchewan, Manitoba, and North Dakota to test and critique the Bourgault air planter in a variety of crop types, implement configuration, and soil conditions. Bourgault greatly values their expertise and experience, and often their patience, when helping us to prove out and refine our products. The next few minutes includes comments from several producers who participated in the 2020 Air Planter Cooperator Program.
Hi, I'm Dustin Holton. We farm in southeast Saskatchewan, southwest Manitoba. Farm with my dad. We got 9,500 acres. We farm canola, peas, barley, oats, and wheat, and corn. We've done 150 acres of corn and 745 acres of canola so far, and we're going to be doing a quarter section of soybeans to try it out. Okay. We're really interested in trying it. We've ran planters in the past and just cutting rates on the canola a little bit kind of thing, and it's just nice to have it in one pass, doing everything in one pass, because just as a regular planter, got to go work your field ahead, put the fertilizer down, just a lot of extra time, whereas if we can get away with this, it saves a lot of time, just if we can do it in one pass. The chief did really good, yeah. Yeah, I mean, digging around the ground, I mean, you see it singulating perfect and kind of thing, so I mean, we'll see when the crop comes up, but so far what we've seen, it's been really good. We cut back our rate. I did different trials on rates anywhere from 1.5 pounds or I think 150,000 seeds up to 450,000 seeds, just to see different rates, how much we can cut down. I mean, if you can cut them back some, and then still do it all in one pass, that saves from buying another planter. So the corn, I tried anywhere from 34,000 to 36,500 seeds per acre on 20-inch spacing, I guess it was. Yeah, simple otherwise, yeah, to set. I mean, it's just like any other planter. You got to change out your disc and stuff like that. But once everything's filled and goed, it's all on the monitor. You put your seeds per acre and away you go kind of thing. It's very good. Yeah, going back and forth volumetric, all it is a flip of a lever underneath your tank. Once you shut it off, you can go right back to volumetric very quickly. Yeah. Yeah. We were doing 350 pounds in the corn. I can't remember exact numbers. It's about 140 nitrogen and 45 phos. And then in a canola, we're doing variable rate anywhere from 200 pounds to 360 pounds.
And all one pass?
All one pass, yes. Okay. Yeah, okay. All through the bander. It's all, like I said, buried in the ground. Whereas otherwise, if we're using a planter, we're broadcasting it ahead, working it up, and then there's fertilizer on top. It's not all in the ground kind of thing. So.
My name is Scott Carefoot. We farm near Swift Current, Saskatchewan. We're typically pulse crops, durum, canola kind of farm. I used the planter for canola this spring. Seeded about 3,100 acres with it. Try to get the even seed rate is the big draw for me, and placement and everything else. It worked good, worked really good actually. So I was pushing a pretty high seeding rate for a planter still, and speed, but it did a nice job still. The motors kept up, very little trouble that way. 425,000, okay. So pretty high rate for that. I was still kind of targeting the 6.5 plants per square foot. First year, see how it does, cut it back the next year. I did some trials, and we'll see how they actually come back at. From first glance, it looks more daunting than it actually is. Once you do it once, it's pretty good. The meter pressures for all to hold the seeds to the plate, very little trouble with that. It went several thousand acres without even having to adjust it, especially through morning with cold oil or night with dense air. It still maintained nice, good positive pressure. So the process to switch is, once you do it once, you can probably switch out back to volumetrically in a minute and a half kind of thing. And even switching out at beforehand, easiest to drop your sump, and then the inductor on the tank is, just move a slide gate and it will start pulling. So that was pretty easy. The clean out is very good too. Yeah, it still has to go down a tube to get to the boot, which is the thing, but it's not doing it down the row perfect, but it's the ultra accurate metering is what I liked about it. The meters work really well. They're quick and easy to take apart, whether you're cleaning it or changing something or just looking at it. The covers come off quick, the metering plates come out easy. All the parts are very accessible. So it's the same old thing with the rising equipment costs. For 3,000 acres of canola, it doesn't make sense to buy a $500,000 planter. And then with this being having the ability to make it a single pass with your fertilizer placement as well, it makes a big benefit. I haven't studied planters that much, but I don't think there's many out there that are set up for banding fertilizer, not like the way this is. So I'm not even sure how they do it on some. Most of it's just a little bit of starter liquid, I think. There's enough guys out there with floaters spreading. I'm personally still not very comfortable with that, just because the studies show you are losing a fair bit through volatilization. So anytime you can band it instead of having to do an extra pass floating, and even there's another, the floaters aren't cheap either. So being able to make it a one pass operation is a big benefit.
My name is Brooks here. I farm near a small town of Douglas. It's in the central part of North Dakota. We grow wheat, canola, soybeans, and corn. We volumetrically sowed wheat and beans with the air planter. We probably did 1,500 acres volumetrically with it. we singulated canola and soybeans with the air planter, and we singulated probably somewhere in the neighborhood of 1,000 acres. Some of the things that intrigued me about the air planter were the differences going from a hoe type opener to a disc opener, seeing the seed placement. Also with the air planter, singulating out the seed, seeing what the seed spacing was. Those were probably a couple of the biggest things that were interesting. When we singulated, we ran at a slightly lower rate than when we were volumetrically seeding. We didn't lower it too much for the fear of just everything new, just to make sure everything was working 100%. We did lower it probably probably close to 10% on the canola, 5% on the soybeans. When we singulated, we did a relatively good job of getting the rates that we wanted. Canola was quite good. We did struggle a little bit in soybeans. We had some real large soybean seed. When we switched the soybean seed to a different variety that was a smaller seed, it did much better, much more accurate as far as the plant population. In the beginning, when you look at it, it's kind of overwhelming. There's a lot of stuff there. Overall, quite simple to set. Operation of the air planter was relatively easy also. As far as setting and operating the X35, worked good. Everything was accurate. There was no big issues with it. The mid-row banders worked great to one pass. It's nice to be able to do it. Some guys are using a planter to plant canola, but you really don't have a good way to get all your N down, where here you can, whether like ourselves putting anhydrous down, or if you're using urea, you can put it all down mid-row band, one pass. It is super nice that way. Overall, worked well, very accurate. The 3820 did a great job holding the seed depth. The singulation is definitely of interest, seeing the accurate placement of the seeds, the spacing of the seeds, the delivery of the seeds. As far as the air planter, if you're looking for a dual purpose machine, something that you can volumetrically seed with, something you can plant with, I think it's a great option. It's super easy to change from volumetric to planting. A very quick, easy process. So far, my experience has been it's worked good. I'd like to see the crop come up, see how the singulation works before I make any recommendations of how I think it performed in the final end. But to this point, I think it's done very well and could be a great tool for someone that just is a little bit on the fence if they want to buy a planter, or if they could get a machine that could do both jobs, be a good fit.
All right, Brennan, we better wrap up today's session here. Everybody's seen a lot of material, but I do want to summarize. With this air planter product, we are one of the first companies, if not the first company, that can offer seed place starter fertilizer down the seed row while you're singulating seed. We're also the first company to offer an air hole drill system with a planter, and also keeping in mind all those abilities to place nutrients down the mid-row banner, whether it be liquid fertilizer, dry fertilizer, or anhydrous, or a combination of those. We have all those abilities. Brennan, anything else you need to add?
I think you pretty much got it there, Curtis. I mean, we're bringing precision to air seeding and capacity to planting.
That's really a great, all way we're doing to, here. Great way to summarize that. Make sure you go and see your local Bourgault dealer for more information on the Bourgault air planter.